Anything other than core visceral tribalism has been boiled away. That's what this is. Let's set aside for a second the fact that what Hillary Clinton was accused of doing with a private unsecured email is like a little anthill compared to the Empire State Building of this operational security nightmare. But what is plain from all of this testimony is we know the answer. He did it. All of this evidence, this huge accumulation of evidence from highly credible witnesses over and over and over shows us that what we saw initially on that summary of the Trump-Zelensky call is in fact what happened. Mm-hmm. He pressured Vladimir Zelensky, a vulnerable new leader of a country at war with Russia, under attack from Russia. He pressured them to get an investigation of the Bidens. Now, Republicans can pretend to have a defense. They can say they can try to impeach people as never Trumpers. None of that is good faith. They don't have a serious argument that it didn't happen. The only question now is, what do you do about it? Is it impeachable? That's a fair debate, right? Or you can talk about the president's state of mind, which gets a little close to an insanity defense, because as David suggested, we know that this To call it a conspiracy theory allows the possibility that the conspiracy is true. No, it's not true. It's not. We know that it's not true.
That's exactly.
Russia interfered, mm-hmm. and that line of argument is an attempt to absolve Russia and absolve the Trump campaign. The facts have been established, and now the question is, what do we as a country do with it?
And right. we'll need one-